Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org. I'm going to bring up a topic, Wimbledon and player housing. Now, most people don't recognize or realize that the players receive from the tournament a daily allowance for what they call their living expenses beyond their prize money. As I remember, it was about $300 US a day, something like that. Could be more now. I included their housing costs, and also if they wanted to spend food. Now, that was very important for the majority of players who had turned the tournament, because not everybody who plays is a multimillionaire, and some of them, they're just surviving year by year. A few of them, they make quite a lot of money for a few years, and then that's it for them. Everybody recognizes that. So player housing is very important. Now, some players choose the hotel housing because it includes the official hotels. It includes the car picking you up at the hotel, taking you back to the tournament, like that. And the hotel's nice to stay in. It's usually in the middle of the business district, or you know, they have the player party nearby. So there's some advantages to that. But there are other players who choose to stay in their own hotels because they can get lower costs and they can pocket the difference with the per diem money, or they can stay with families that are nearby the tournament, and usually they can stay for free. Now, I was able to be with many players who were staying with families. I actually have helped players stay with families, found Christian families for them to stay with, especially I was very much drawn to people who were struggling financially, and another time I'll talk about those kind of players, but they would stay with the players. They would take the money and put it in their pocket, and then they would get the families that they were staying with tickets to the tournament, or they would get them their credential, because they are allowed two or three credentials to get in the tournament. They would give it to the people they stayed with, and that was really an exchange process. And you know, how that impacted me as a Christian, I felt, because I was involved in encouraging churches to get housing for players, I felt that it was really not the right thing to do. A Christian family who wanted to house a player really should have done that on their own, willingly, without expecting anything in return. And there were many cases where the people that players stayed with expected them to give them a credential. I had one person tell me, who I stayed with for a few years, and they were in the habit of that with players through a French coach who would always arrange that kind of arrangement. I spoke to him about that. I said, I don't feel that's the right thing to do. It doesn't present a real Christian witness, and didn't go anywhere. And I stayed there, and that person said, well, we're housing you. I'm a pastor reaching out to players. You should get us free tickets to the tournament. Well, I was put in a very tough position because I was staying with them, and on the other hand, they were expecting me to get them at least tickets to the tournament, and I just don't go around and ask players for favors because I don't feel that's my responsibility there. But that kind of shows you the position that we were put in, we meaning I. So what I would like to share about the housing is, you know, I tried to encourage the churches to set up housing as a ministry. Now, the way most of the churches would do it is they would just encourage their members to do that on their own. But there weren't really any guidelines for that. For example, you know, with the tickets or the credentials, how about if a player brought in their girlfriend and they weren't married, that's happened, or their boyfriend, they weren't married, they stayed in the same room. That happened with